For much of 2019, reported gun crimes were down across Memphis and Shelby County, but the same can't be said for violent crimes in juveniles.
The Memphis Shelby Crime Commission works with area authorities to come up with ways to curb crime and violence. And here to look ahead to the new year is President Bill Gibbons with the Memphis Shelby Crime Commission. Bill Gibbons, welcome back to Live and I'm glad to have you here.
Alex, good to be here.
I know a lot of strides were definitely made when it comes to crime in Memphis and Shelby County, especially in recent months. How do you think we're going to fare for the entire year, though?
Well, the final figures aren't in yet, obviously. It'll be about 3 weeks before we get those final figures. But preliminarily, things look pretty good in terms of moving in the right direction. Overall crime appears to be going down this year. When I say overall crime, I'm talking about everything together. Major violent crime is hopefully going to be going down this year, mainly driven by a pretty significant reduction in reported robberies. Mm-hmm. Domestic violence appears to be going down, and major property crime, driven primarily by some pretty significant reductions in burglaries and auto thefts.
I was going to ask you, what do you think has really made a difference in 2019? I was reading where some people say you have to take ownership of crime in Memphis and Shelby County and here in the Mid-South. What has made a difference, you think, for those communities still having issues?
Well, and let me point out, we're not yet where we need to be. While we can take some comfort in hoped reductions this year, we have a long way to go. But I think a number of things are helping. First of all, I think the Memphis Police Department is doing a good job of deploying its resources in a data-driven way, making sure police officers are in the right places at the right times. We don't have enough police officers, but I think they're doing a good job of deploying what they have. Number two, I think we're doing a much better job in terms of focusing on those serious offenders through something called focused deterrence. There's been a lot of talk about a book called Bleeding Out. Councilman-elect Jeff Warren has been distributing copies of this book. But basically what that book advocates is a focused deterrence approach, really focusing on those most serious offenders and sending them a clear message that they either have to straighten up and change their behavior or face the consequences. And we're beginning to do that in this community with some good results, I think.
As you look at some of these different approaches, such as data-driven policing and others that you just mentioned, what about a long-term approach? Because you'll have some who sit here and watch this and say, look, until we get to the root of some of these issues, which stem from many things, then we can't just solve it, even with adding more police. So what about some of those bigger picture approaches that addresses really the fact that, you know, things that people are living with day to day, especially in our impoverished communities?
Yeah. Well, you have to have both. You have to have some steps that can have a short-term impact and look at steps that can have a long-term impact. I think a good example of what you're talking about is something that we hope to get really up and running in 2020, and that is what's called a youth assessment center, to take those juveniles who are facing charges for nonviolent offenses, property crimes and so on, get them into an assessment center, assess what's going on in their lives and their families' lives, and try to address those issues so there's not a second encounter with law enforcement, and try to move them in the right direction. I think that kind of front-end approach of really trying to address the problem can have a very positive long-term impact as well as short-term impact.
Because for those who don't know, juvenile crime is still a major issue here in Memphis and Shelby County. Where do we stack up there, Bill Gibbons, when it comes to juvenile crime, and what can be done, perhaps?
Well, Alex, I told you preliminarily all the crime figures look pretty good. The one exception is a pretty significant increase in the number of juveniles being charged with serious violent crimes. And I think in 2020, you're going to see all of us who are involved in this really focusing on that and really trying to come up with some effective steps to address it. When you think about it, it's a fairly limited number of juveniles that we're talking about. When you look at the data, at the end of the year, there are probably going to be around 200 juveniles charged with aggravated robbery, for example. Now, that's way too many, but it's a manageable number, and we ought to be smart enough to figure out how to address that problem.
And very quickly here, before we run out of time, what about a call from some state lawmakers from Memphis in the legislature saying that there should be a restructuring of the sentencing for juvenile offenders who have committed murders? Do you see that being the way to go there?
I think it needs to be discussed in a broader context. First of all, we're talking about juveniles who have been transferred to criminal court to be tried as adults, not left in the juvenile court system. Under current law, they're not eligible for the death penalty. They're not eligible for life without parole. They are eligible for life with parole, which currently means eligible for parole after serving 51 years. What some legislators want to do is change that to make them eligible for parole after serving, say, 25 years. Yeah. I think that needs to be discussed in the broader context of our sentencing laws, and that's one thing that's going to be discussed a lot in 2020.
Okay.
To make sure we're making smart use of our prison space for those that need to be out of our neighborhoods and off our streets.
All right. Bill Gibbons, thank you very much for taking the time to be with us. Happy New Year to you.
Same to you.
All right.